Now we discuss psoriatic arthritis. Psoriatic arthritis is people that have psoriasis that develop arthritis. And so 5 to 7% of persons with psoriasis will develop some form of an inflammatory joint disease. It affects 0.1% of the population. And interesting enough, male and female ratio is equal before an ankylosing spondylitis and Reiter syndrome. Males dominated females, and in females dominated males and autoimmune diseases, but in psoriatic arthritis, it's about equal. The ages are 30 to 55, it's more common in whites, and it's also associated with HIV, because HIV decreases the immune system. Perhaps there's some kind of mechanism that's going on there. The pathogenesis is unknown, but there is a genetic HLA-B27 marker that's positive that correlates with psoriatic arthritis. Environmental factors, or there are infections or trauma, and there's some kind of immunological play in this, but the pathogenesis is unknown. So the clinical manifestations, the skin and nails is psoriatic skin lesions, they're erythematous, and you have silvery scales. And here is a picture of most common sites. Yeah, in the scalp, around the ears, the elbows, the gluteal cleft, umbilicus, the nails, the genitalia region, the knees, and the toenails. So here are some pictures of the knees, and here is a picture of around the ears and the scalp. So you can kind of see these silvery erythematous, this reddened region scale type stuff. That's psoriasis. You also have Auschwitzsein. I think it's just some German doctor that created this. But if you gently scrape off the lesions, then you get pinpoint bleeding. So over in this picture, if you see how there's kind of a bleeding here, a bleeding here, a bleeding here, you get the pinpoint lesion or bleeding, which is called Auschwitzsein. It's located over the extensor surfaces, and you also get what they call nail pitting. So right here, you can kind of see there's these pits in these nails. Remember that in Reiter syndrome, it was non-pitting and opacity of the nails. Here, you get pitting. So you get arthritis or inflammation of joints. You have stiffness of the spine lasting 30 minutes or so, and usually that's in the morning. Asymmetric, so one side's affected more than the other. You have oligo or few or monoarticular problems. You get the large joints, so like the knees, the distal interphalangeal joint. The dips are involved usually. You have arthritis militans, is osteolysis of the phalanges and metacarpals of the hand resulting in telescoping of the finger. And this is a really kind of an interesting scenario here. So you have a patient's hand here, and you get osteolysis, which means destruction or eating away of the bone. And so what happens is this finger becomes short. It's not like the other ones are growing longer. It's actually this finger and this finger become short. And this is in severe cases, of course. But these fingers become short, and so it's called telescoping of the finger. So it appears that this one is like growing, but in reality these two are becoming shorter because of the bone destruction. And in Reiter syndrome, you also get enthesopathy, is inflammation of the enthesis, or where the ligaments, tendons, joint capsules, fascia insert into the bone. You get spondylitis, which is inflammation of the spine, and sacroiliitis. You can also get conjunctivitis, kind of like Reiter syndrome, and you can get aortic insufficiency. The lab findings are kind of vague on this. They're not specific, no lab tests specific for psoriatic. Mostly it's just see if the patient has psoriasis and then develops arthritis. It's the increased incidence of patients with a positive HLA-B27. And last but not least, let's look at some of the radiographic findings. Again, you see this penicillin cup appearance mostly in the DIPs. So this joint here, this joint here, this joint here. What it has is this bone here becomes more of like a pencil, and then that, and then this bone right here becomes more like a cup. So that's the pencil in the, that's the pencil in the cup appearance. You have asymmetric sacroiliitis, and you can have a fusion of that, and you can have fluffy periostitis, and this is kind of a picture of that. You can get it in the hands, feet, spine, and SI joint. You can kind of see here that right here you're getting some fluffiness or proliferative periostitis. Periosteum is if you have a bone here, and then you have the periosteum, which is this layer that kind of lines the side of a of the bone. Well, this periosteum gets inflamed, which is on the sides here. So it looks like the bone gets bigger, widened, because of this inflammation of the periosteum. Syndesmus fights, talked about that in the last video, where you have an intervertebral disc here, or sorry, a vertebra, and then you have an IVD, intervertebral disc here, and then you have this ligament that comes down all the front of your spine, and this is called the ALL. Well, this syndesmophyte's on an X-ray, you can kind of, let's say, if you can kind of start seeing it ossify. You can kind of start seeing this become ossified and more opaque, more white. And so you can kind of see that that's going to eventually fuse if the disease becomes too bad. And you get bone erosion. So that's it for psoriatic arthritis.